arguably the greatest sleight of hand artist of the past 100 years was a guy by the name of Charlie Miller. And in 1968, Charlie Miller sat down with a 25-year-old magician by the name of David Alexander in Los Angeles. And Charlie taught David a trick. And David went on for the next 40 years, performed it all around the globe. And for him, in his hands, that trick was the spectacular finale of an amazing show. In 2006, David retired. And when he retired, he decided that he was going to give that piece as an inheritance to one performer. But there were conditions. He gave it to a performer in Canada, but on the condition that this performer was never allowed to sell the secret to another magician. He was never allowed to tell the secret to another magician or teach it to another magician. But when the time was right, he was going to choose another performer, give it to him under the same conditions, and hopefully the chain would persist on down. Now, the more observant among you will notice my sleeves are rolled up, the coat is neatly buttoned. Ladies and gentlemen, this is my opportunity to disappoint three generations of magic masters. But what you're about to see, you honestly will not see from any other performer anywhere in the world. This is a bag of secrets. Bag of secrets. It is a soft velvet bag. It's got a couple interesting features to this, right? It's got this very attractive lining within the inside as we come through there. It is also manufactured out of this very soft, light, velvety material. We've seen it from the outside on the outside. We've seen it with the inside on the outside. Another interesting feature is that my hand just about entirely fills the bag, so there's very little room for anything else. Ladies and gentlemen, the ancient mystery of the little bag of secrets. Some who saw this when David did it were convinced that the bag was haunted, that anyone who dared put his hand inside risked eternal punishment for cavorting with the spirits.